We all know the euro crisis. The euro crisis in reality is hiding something which is a lot more severe than what you see on television and newspapers. It is a financial coup d'etat. There has been a financial coup d'etat defined as markets who are external to any sovereign country, who are not elected by any sovereign government, who have actually imposed a political and economic agenda on several countries in Europe, who have crashed any democratic hope for a sovereign handling of the economy, like in Greece, where the referendum, which is one of the main means for democratic handling of a country, has been crushed by these people. So there has been a financial coup d'etat. This financial coup d'etat is actually aiming at destroying a part of Europe for the benefit of a very tiny elite of speculators, of neo-mercantile industrialists, particularly in Germany, and of the neoliberal agenda in general. We hear every day smaller governments, austerity, we hear deflation of wages, we hear people having problems with their, you know, not being able to get their pensions, having to give up pensions for a number of years. And this is the typical neoliberal agenda that's behind what you read in newspapers as the euro crisis, particularly the euro as a sovereign means of as a sovereign money is the chief instrument for the final success of this financial coup d'etat. Why? Because it's not sovereign. It's not a sovereign monetary means. It's a unit of account. It's money that's been issued by a system of central banks directly into the accounts of private financial institutions. And the sovereign states are reduced to the point of having to borrow this money from banks, sovereign funds, insurance companies, hedge funds, speculators' funds. So you have a sovereign state which is not sovereign anymore and has to borrow all this money, the money that it needs to function, from these private institutions. The euro has done this trick, and it's been done on purpose precisely to further this neoliberal agenda. So what we need now is sound economics, is state-centered economics, is people-centered economics, is a sovereign state regaining a sovereign currency to spend it, to deficit spend it, which means spend it more than they tax people, to create full employment, to create full education, to create full housing, and to create full social security, and even to help companies, private companies, small, medium businesses fulfill their expectation in sales, because the state with a sovereign currency can help productivity as much as it wants. We need this. We need to go back to the state of affairs, which has a very long tradition. It's an economic system which had its roots in a very honorable and authoritative tradition in economics. We're talking about Keynes, Minsky, Godley, Lerner, Knapp, John Robinson, these great economists of the 20th century. They created this system, this new way to allow states to regain their full sovereign powers for the benefit of the majority. The thinking was short-lived. The neoliberal elites strived for 30 to 40 to 50 years to crush completely this economic apparatus, to hide it from view, to hide it from people. We need this thing to come back. Now, the modern version of this democratic way to handle the economy is called modern money theory. It's an economic school of economics. It's an American school of economics. It has its center at the University of Missouri, Kansas City, and the Levy Institute, Bard College in New York. We are inviting these economists to Italy to explain to the Italian people how to defend themselves from the financial coup d'etat, how to allow Italy to regain its monetary sovereignty, and how to use that monetary sovereignty for the benefit of the majority. Be very careful here, because you will object that the United States of America or Britain do have a sovereign currency. And how come they are in such a poor state of affairs? Well, the reason is that they're not applying modern money theory. They're not applying this economic system of expenditure that benefits for the people. They can issue as much money as they want. They just issue it to further the elite and not for the people. The United States of America has printed, let's say printed, $29 trillion in the last 3 years. Where do they go? To a tiny 1% of elites, of bankers and financial institutions. If this money had been spent for the people, America would be a different country. And the same applies to Britain. So we are bringing these people here to explain to us how to create a democratic system that uses economic means to further the well-being of the majority of the people, of the 99%. The summit will be held in Italy, in Tuscany possibly, perhaps in February. For the dates and the final arrangements, you have to see my website, which is www.paolobarnard.info. And everything is there.